In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We celebrate today the memorial of Saint Maximilian Kolbe. Through his intercession, we beg for the grace that we may follow our Lord Jesus as our Mother Mary would teach us. In a special way, we also pray for our local church here in Manila as we celebrate the 429th anniversary of the elevation of Manila as an archdiocese. And we also pray for our brothers and sisters in our neighboring dioceses who celebrate also the day of their establishment, namely the Diocese of Cebu, Diocese of Nueva Segovia, and Diocese of Nueva Cáceres. As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and acknowledge the Lord's mercy and pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who filled the priest and martyr, Saint Maximilian Kolbe, with a burning love for the Immaculate Virgin Mary, and with zeal for souls and love of neighbor, graciously grant through his intercession that striving for your glory by eagerly serving others, we may be conformed even until death to your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord cried loud for me to hear, "Come, you scourges of the city." With that, I saw six men coming from the direction of the upper gate, which faces the north, each with a destroying weapon in his hand. In their midst was a man dressed in linen, with a writer's case at his waist. They entered and stood beside the bronze altar. Then he called to the man dressed in linen, with a writer's case at his waist, saying to him, "Pass through the city, through Jerusalem, and mark a tau on the foreheads of those who moan and groan over all the abominations that are practiced within it." To the others, I heard the Lord say, "Pass through the city after him and strike. Do not look on them with pity, nor show any mercy. Old men, youths and maidens, women and children, wipe them out. But do not touch any mark with a tau. Begin at my sanctuary." So they began with the men, the elders, who were in front of the temple. "Defile the temple," he said to them, "and fill the courts with the slain. Then go out and strike in the city." Then the glory of the Lord left the threshold of the temple and rested upon the cherubim. These lifted their wings, and I saw them rise from the earth, the wheels rising along with them. They stood at the entrance of the eastern gate of the Lord's house, and the glory of the Lord and the glory of the God of Israel was up above them. Then the cherubim lifted their wings, and the wheels went along with them, while up above them was the glory of the God of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high, and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
One of the famous lines of Saint Maximilian Kolbe are these words: "Hate is not a powerful force, only love is a creative power." Hate is not a powerful force, only love is a creative power. Why is there such a thing as hate? Bakit ba natin kinamumuhian ang isang tao, bagay, o pangyayari? Simply because we got hurt. We hate the feeling of getting hurt. We don't want to get hurt, and it is a natural tendency for us as human persons. Self-preservation would dictate that we avoid things or places that we could get hurt. And when we are emotionally hurt, we also shun away people who have hurt or may hurt us. Kaya kinamumuhian natin yung isang tao kasi nasaktan nila tayo. Kinamumuhian natin yung isang pangyayari kasi hindi maganda yung karanasan natin. Kaya anong nangyayari? Ayaw nating makita yung tao. Ayaw nating maulit yung pangyayari. Ayaw nating maalaala yung karanasan. Ayaw natin. At kapag inayawan natin ang isang tao o pangyayari, para bang pinuputol na natin yung connection natin dun sa taong iyon. Pinuputol natin yung alaala ng karanasan na iyon. Self-preservation builds up the hate so that we can prevent ourselves in getting hurt once again. When we hate, we disconnect people. When we hate, we disconnect memories. When we hate, there is a big tendency that we close into ourselves and shut out the world in front of us. Going back to the words of Saint Maximilian Kolbe and the words of Jesus in our gospel, it is only love who can recreate the damage that hate has brought. When we hate, we disconnect. But when we love, we build bridges. We reconstruct harmony. Kung kinamuhian tayo ng Diyos sa mga pagkakasala natin, matagal na tayong wala. Pero hindi ganun ang Diyos. Dahil patuloy niya tayong pinapanibago ng kanyang pagmamahal. God did not hate us because of our sins, but He allows His love to renew and recreate us. Do we hate someone because they have done something to us? Let us be careful then that hate might explode within us and destroy our capacity to love. Kaya nga, sabi din nila, no? Hate the sin, but not the sinner. Why? Because we must destroy our connection to sin so that we may be able to love more as a person. And as we are able to love more as a person, we are able to reestablish our connection to God and to our brothers and sisters as well.
Please stand.
If Jesus tells us today, if two of you agree to ask something, it will be granted to you by my Father in heaven. So we pray together and say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of the church may be drawn close together, living in peace and harmony. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of nations may respect the rights of every person and avoid repression and atrocities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have the courage to speak the truth with love and accept criticisms graciously. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick, the aged, and the housebound may see God's comfort and consolation in the compassion of those who care for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may be cleansed and prepared for eternal unity in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, we lift up to the Lord our personal intentions, remembering all the people who are asking for our prayers and for all the people whom we promised to pray for. Heavenly Father, with your Son in our midst, we ask you to help us believe in the goodness of each person and be patient with one another as you have been good to us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
We present our oblations to you, O Lord, humbly praying that we may learn from the example of Saint Maximilian to offer our very lives to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr, Maximilian, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness, through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Maximilian Kolbe, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that renewed by the body and blood of your Son, we may be inflamed with the same fire of charity that Saint Maximilian received from this holy banquet. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We continue to invite you to pray with us this evening, our Wednesday Family Rosary, tonight at 9 in the evening. You may follow us, our Family Rosary, through our YouTube and Facebook pages. Our rosary will be led by the Filipino Chaplaincy in Padova, Italy. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.